Okay, are you ready?
Ready.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, friends and colleagues at Kapiya sa Manila Bay. We are here again and our favorite Suki of Kapiya sa Manila Bay, our very good dear friend, National Security Advisor Herman Dennis Escalon Jr. But before anything else, I would like to greet our good National Security Advisor a happy anniversary. The Office of the National Security Advisor celebrates today its 69th founding anniversary, sir. So, good morning, sir. To start off the day's breakfast forum, let us hear about your 69th anniversary. With President Duterte later at 3 p.m., who will be the guest of honor.
Thank you very much, my dear friend, Incho. Of course, the Kapiyan sa Maynila and Philippine Star. To all those who are here with us today, magandang umaga sa inyong lahat. At tulad ng nasabi ni Incho, today is the 69th anniversary of the National Security Council and the 70th for NICA. Combined kami. And sadly, the enemy is us, meaning us, the Filipino. We are our own demons. Further down the line, he said, catharsis is what we need, individually or collectively. It is what we need today, not tomorrow, today. Self-purgation followed by the resolve to do what is right and proper is good for the nation's health. And so we take off from that. And I must say, I must explain that I take it as a reminder not only to the public in general, to the Filipino public, but more specifically to ourselves in government. In other words, there is no way that we could serve the Filipino people if we do not take the necessary reforms. It is only when you have a reformed heart and mind that you will be able to serve the people better. And so, true enough, we have seen purges, catharsis in government. You remember field health. You remember the initial 64 in the Bureau of Customs. 100 more will be coming out. At the newly appointed foreign office of the anti-red tape agency, they have apprehended people at the Land Transport LTFRB, Land Transport Franchising Regulatory Board, who have been choking permits for personal gains. At the PACC, you have reported to yourselves the apprehension of two revenue district revenue officers, who were demanding 75% of what they have computed to be the deficit. And there they were, collecting more than what was about to go to government. And of course now, in the thick of all these things, we were one night surprised by the personal announcement by the President of the closure of all gambling activities run by PCSO. And so we take note that still there are complaints at the LTO, the SSS, BIR, LRA, and PATIBIC in terms of their rendition of services to the people. Why do I have to go through this? It is because the National Security Agency, partnered with the National Intelligence Coordinating Agency, are major players in counterintelligence or in gathering of information in order to take out the demons among us. And that is exactly where we are starting, since it is our anniversary today, as we go about in the other big jobs that we have been assigned, including the matter of ending the local communist armed conflict, addressing violent extremism, of course, corruption, and illegal drugs. And so, I am now ready to update you on what has been happening in the in our fight against the CPP, NPA, NDF, or what we call the CTG, as well as the local terrorists that have been affiliated with the ISIS or foreign terrorists. So I am ready to take questions, including, of course, on the West Philippine Sea, where I am now the National Task Force Commander since 3 years back.
Okay, thank you, sir. But your opening statement speaks of looking at the mirror and seeing ourselves. But if we look outside the mirror, the internal security threats around us, you have mentioned already a while ago, gives us more concern that this internal security threats in our country than before when you first entered, or have you at least lessened the threats to a certain degree?
After 3 years in the administration, I must say that starting with the secessionist narrative, when we say secessionist narrative, we talk about the MNLF and the MILF uprisings and struggle starting from the 60s, 70s onwards. Today, we have passed the Bangsamoro Organic Law and have, in fact, created and appointed the Bangsamoro Transition Authority, which is now working as executive branch as well as parliament, a local parliament. In other words, what we used to see before as Mindanao always troubled, especially in what we now know as the autonomous region, we have now a functioning, we may even say, a better government for the autonomous region. And so what do we have now? The Abu Sayyaf, the PIFF, and remnants thereof, multi-group and smaller groups. And so even Bravo, who used to be a big man in the PIFF,
he's now part of the BPA, right?
Yes, a member of the BPA. So in that aspect, we have improved so much on that.
But BIF is still actively fighting the government. In fact, 7 of the release of the previous sentence.
Yes, they continue to have their fight against government, but the bulk of their forces are now being controlled by Bravo, Commander Bravo, and what they are now engaged in or busy with. Nagtatanim na sila doon sa mga lugar nila. At nagiging plantations na yung lugar nila. So there is both transformation. Nagbabago yung pag-iisip at saka yung mga ginagawa natin sa baba. Malaking bagay para sa amin yon, lalo na sa armed forces. Dahil nabibigyan kami ng mas maraming panahon, mas maraming pagkakataon, mas maraming pwersa upang labanin yung mga talagang lumalaban pa na mga elemento ng Abu Sayyaf, PIFF, Maute, etc. So, that's the secessionist narrative. We no longer have to worry about it.
But the ISIS, diba?
We are now better situated.
Okay.
But the ISIS, as we all know, have been very determined in getting into Mindanao. And they even think that they could establish their wilayat or their province with in the Southeast Asia with its center in Mindanao. Kung kaya't inipilit nilang makakuha ng mas marami at makapagparating pa dito ng mga foreign terrorists. At talaga namang matindi rin yung kanilang dating dahil kaya nilang magbomba.
Yeah.
This is now the Pasilan, Lamitan bombing, suicide bombing was part of it.
Sulu.
Then the Katulu Cathedral bombing, which we have now identified to be perpetrated by Indonesian couple. And of course, the latest one being in Danan, yung kauna-una lang nagkaroon tayo ng Filipino suicide bomber. But and so all the works continue there. Let me just assure you that with the division, we now have a dedicated force with 3 brigades in Hulo. Plus additional forces.
In figures, how is it?
Well, that comes to about, as of now, about 7,000 men with, I think, including a division usually has 9 battalions, but we have 12 battalions there, including 1 Marine Brigade. And was went on stowaway.
Who's that?
Yung nagbomba na seaside bomber sa Hulo.
Ah, okay.
So umalis yun sa bahay nila nung 14 years old siya. At 19 years old, he was ready to commit the suicide bombing. So we should be able to prevent those kinds of lone wolves or organization-created persons that would commit violent extremism. How do we do it? We must address the community itself. Meron tayong effort yan. We must have efforts in schools. We must have efforts in the sector of religious scholars who go abroad and come back. We must have an effort on OFWs. We must have efforts in the social media. And we must also have efforts in the what we call the Islamic schools or the madaris, in the same manner that we also take care of the schools, whether they are Muslim, Islamic or not. So lahat ng vulnerable sectors will now be addressed by different agencies with a central direction.
Oh.
With a central direction.
NSA.
It is run by the Anti-Terrorism Council,
which is headed by.
It's headed by the Executive Secretary. I am a member of that. I volunteered to craft the.
Which is by the U.S. and the.
By the U.S., by Canada, by New Zealand, by Europe. So tayo na lang ang hindi pa umaamin na terorista pala sila.
So, ano ang status of peace talks natin? No, no more localized na lang.
We will now go to localized peace talks. And we now have, the President has created the National Task Force to end the local communist armed conflict. And he has taken the helm.
Di ba siya dapat June pa yung
nilalunch? He has taken the helm. The plans were approved last April.
Oh.
And we are now organizing and creating the lines of efforts or clusters at the national level and the regional level. Papunta na kami sa probinsya, munisipyo at barangay, and we are soon ready to launch. But remember, since the threat has always been there, nandiyan naman yung threat talaga, and our troops are there and our government is there, we had actually been planning. But while we are planning and organizing, we are also performing because we have to. So, nandun na kami. The President has taken the helm, as I have said, I happen to be the vice chairman. The president has also designated 17 members of the cabinet to become cabinet officer for regional development and security in all regions. We have seen before the functioning of the court. But this time, it takes another added responsibility, which is taking care and leading the regional task force.
So it's now called courts.
It's now courts. And he is in charge of the Regional Development Council and the existing, another council that is existing, the Regional Peace and Order Council.
RPOC. And the National Peace and Order.
And the, so, yung dalawang yun dati ay pambihirang nagsasama sa mga plano, mga gawain, meetings. Now, it's now the whole of government that will address the affected areas.
Whole of nation approach, diba? Tawag yun.
Yes, while our armed component will address the armed group, itong civilian bureaucracy will now go to the geographically isolated and depressed areas and the affected areas, as well as areas that have high incidence of poverty. Yun ang aming mga target nila.
Before I go to WPS on external threats, I would like to take on your opening statement that I'm under the impression that the NSA has raised to threat level the corruption problem in government. Am I correct with that impression that the post-SONA scenario that you have mentioned, the incident, several cases?
Well, the matter of corruption has been always something that we had to address.
You said kasi may mga intelligence assets kayo na based on those intelligence information, we went after the contract kayo and everything. Is NSA part of that or RICA?
We are part of it, but at the same time, remember that we have created such agencies as PACC and the ATA, the new ATA. And we still have the NBI. We have the police and of course the military. And the Department of Justice, primarily. So what we really need is information gathering. So tututukan natin mas mabuti ito. Kilalang-kilala ninyo yung mayroong bookstore dyan sa Patrick Paura, si F. Chanel Fuset, who said, we have not risen above and beyond the parochial interest. Our work, loyalty to family, friends, and tribal kin continue to exact a heavy toll on our programs designed to uplift the poor and reassure our investors and the business sector in this country. And as I said, much of the early part of the SONA itself was dedicated to on what the president feels about corruption. Na nauso na yung mga parang naging usual na lang yung for the boys, naging usual na lang yung commission. Bawat may mga lamesa na hindi mo malalampasan kung hindi pa magbibigay. So that must change.
Before we leave the communist threat, how about the four cops who were killed by supposedly MTA? Na pinahirap at torture naman and what's the status of that now?
MPA
nga ba yun?
Well, MPA talaga yung kumarang sa kanila. Unfortunately, they were on a patrol mission. They were apprehended. I think two of them were captured. They were tortured and later on on bent knees, they were shut up. How cruel would they have been? And so after that, There have been a series of killings in Negros Oriental.
And now there are talks about martial law in Negros.
There are talks about martial law. I wouldn't bring them because three mayors have even called me. And I said, please allow us to handle it. We have earlier than that. Remember that there was already the killings of 12 farmers by probably a rival group who had problems on land disputes. Land disputes. You may recall, I must say that the antecedent of that was that when Secretary Kapaeng Mariano left, he issued a memorandum to the effect that if lands are under contest or under litigation, the claimants may occupy. In other words, that is nothing less than anarchy.
Yeah.
And so nagsimula yun yung 12 na namatay sa Sagay is part of Homeland. But through the years, nagkaroon ng mga land reform dyan. Mayroon namang mga land reform na nabawi din ng iba na namang landlords. So, hindi na tatanggal yung problema natin dyan. Lalo na kung konti naman yung kinikita mo sa asukal or hindi naman lumalaki yung lupa, dumadami yung tao. So, ano ang sagot natin to? Ang isang primary attraction or bait parang pang-attract ng CPPP ay yung pangako nila na land for the landless, confiscation of lands and we will give you lands. Ay si mga natin, mas marami kang makukuha. So, because of that problem, lumalala yung ating insurgency problem doon sa Negros, for both sides, kasi sa Oriental, lalo na sa Burgan, ay may mga elementary doon. So, what has happened? We have added, we have transferred the brigade from Bohol to Isabela, Negros Occidental. We have strengthened the PNP has redeployed one of its SAF battalions to Negros para maawat natin, for the meantime, yung series of killings. It is unacceptable that to me, to you, to all of us, na bigla na lang yung principal at saka yung asawa niyang nagtuturo din, ay mamamatay.
May mga human rights lawyers na...
May mga lawyers na namamatay. So, we have to investigate all of this. It should not lead to anarchy and open violence. So the president has been very concerned about it, and he has been to Sagay, he has been to the distribution of lands in Negros. We went there, and he again visited the four camps that were victims of CPG atrocities.
Pero ang pinakamaingay dyan, katulad ng karapatan, they came out to that port na citing the Philippines is the most dangerous place for environmental activists, not to mention yung mga human rights lawyers.
Oh, karapatan nga sila, tama. Pero mayroon pa silang sinabi itong karapatan tungkol sa apat na sundalo, apat na polis na kinahirapan bago patayin. Mayroon pa silang sinasabi man lang sa mga biktima ng mga drug-related
But we have the CHR to take up the cost. That's a government independent, supposedly independent government.
Yun nga ang ating laging tinatanong kung ang titignan mo ba bilang Commission on Human Rights ay gobyerno lang. Pero yung karapatan na sa group is really a front organization of the CPP. So, natural na ang titirahin nila yung activities ng government. But as if we are not conscious about human rights, natatandaan ko pa nung chief of staff ako, I created the office for human rights.
Yes.
And it still remains as an office. So human rights is not the exclusive interest or concern of of one sector or the Karakapan.
And they are claiming the global study na the Philippines is the most dangerous place.
Well, hindi ko nga malaman kung bakit nila bakit nandun sila sa panic ng mga crime at mga drug driven crimes.
Environmental activists daw yun, mga victims sa mga human rights.
Saan? Sa drugs?
In general.
In general.
Yung global index na ngayon lumabas na ano.
There is always this talk about human rights. But let it be said that it is not the exclusive domain. Their exclusive domain. In fact, I can always say your soldiers, your police officers are on the side of human rights.
Okay. Yung manamanggit mo na yung martial law. Kung sabihin ka daw, sir, na extension ng martial law, the president sets up to the LGUs, but as far as it's concerned, it's not... He's very cool about that idea of extending martial law.
Ang martial law, as of now, as it is, if I am to recommend, gusto ko pa rin ituloy. Number one,
kala ko ba maayos na?
Number one, I want to shepherd further the growth of the Bangsamoro Transition Authority.
For the remaining half of this term.
Lalo na't nanyan pa ang Abu Sayyaf, ang PIFF at saka Mokotin.
Okay.
Pangalawa, gusto nating maawat yung armed groups. And we do not want them to have so much freedom moving around. Ang binibigay kasi, pangatlo, gusto ko rin i-address itong CPP-NPA which mostly affects the eastern half of Mindanao. For the benefit that martial law gives us, which is 3 days maximum detention period, I will go for it. But, if we can have an amended Human Security Act.
Yeah, Secretary Lozada is also batting for that.
If we can have that, then we may not have martial law. We may not have. Remember, sa mga kapitbayan natin, sa limon ng Singapore, Malaysia, Australia, Indonesia, on mere suspicion alone in Australia, you could be detained for 30 days. Ganon kahigpit. Ganon din sa Singapore. Ganon din sa Malaysia. Tayo ang pinakamahina sa counter-terrorism, sa anti-terrorism. Samantalang, alam na alam natin na napaka-aktibo ng terrorist dito sa Pilipinas. Alam natin na noong Marawi incident, mayroong marami ang namatay doon sa Marawi na foreigners. Marami din tayong nakitang connection sa drugs. Marami tayong nakukuha ng drugs doon sa mga nabawi na nakuha natin mga hideouts nila. And lots of money. Nagtataka ako kung bakit ayaw natin pumayag na gawin natin mas mahusay yung ating Human Security Act upang hindi naman matatakot ang inyong law enforcement officers na gamitin yung batas na yun. Kasi nakalagay ngayon sa batas na yun na kung nagkamali ka ng pag-aresto sa isang tao, no matter how well-intended, no matter how good your intentions are, you will have to pay 500,000 pesos.
The president also declared, ako, sa akin yan, lahat yan sa akin. Is that enough?
Well, that moves our operating troops with much confidence. But in the end, to each, hindi mo naman makikita lahat eh. It's better if everybody is covered by law.
Okay. By law. For presidential...
Well, the president will always say, go ahead and operate.
Akin yan.
Because, akin na. Tama naman. And he will really back you up. But, it is not absolute that he will back you up all the way. Kasi, mayroon din namang nakulong na because of infractions or
violations
of procedures. Sino ba yung sa kalooban? Si Kian, for example. That this is so... taga-Philippine Science High School pa naman yan.
Oh, yeah.
Siguro magandang potential, maraming potential si bata nga, kaya lang hindi ko alam kung bakit napunta siya sa ganun. Siguro ganun din ako nung
anyway, na-mention mo yung mga foreign terrorists, foreign nationals. The Bureau of Immigration reported that for the first 6 months of this year, they have barred entry of more than 2,300 foreign, undesirable aliens. They were barred entry. But half of that number were Chinese, 1,231. Is that an indication that there is indeed influx of Chinese nationals here, especially Congo? We have no visible means to support themselves as tourists kasi tourist visa sila eh.
Una-una sa terorista, talaga namang we have been having exchange of data, one with Interpol where the Bureau of Immigration really gets a lot of data for our advance information yung mga pumapasok. In the exchange of intelligence with neighboring countries as well as Europe and well, Russia and Middle East. Marami na tayong data na nakukuha kasama ng mga data na natin na nakuha sa United States, sa Japan, sa Korea, for example. So, may mga nasasakit tayo. But the border is still porous.
Especially in the south.
But we keep on strengthening our agreement for trilateral cooperation in the common seas of Indonesia, Malaysia, and the Philippines. So, despite that, may nakakapasok pa rin. So, we are trying to do our best. Meron tayong mga ginagamit ngayon na face recognition na gadgets and other things that we employ na medyo technical. Hindi ko pwedeng mag-checkpoint ka at titignan mo yung album mo kung sino yon. Eh, mahirap yun. Kailangan, pag ganyan mo ng cellphone, makita mo na kagad, di ba? Tayo, face recognition na yung iba yung cellphone, di ba?
Yes.
So, ganoon ang principle lang. Pag may data bank, database. On the matter of Chinese coming in, are we surprised about that? Of course, ang nangyayari ngayon, maraming negosyo dito, offshore gaming na pumapasok. Ito ay regulated ng PAGCOR, but there are illegal players, illegal operators. Yun ang problema natin. Because some of these Chinese could come in as tourists and they could end up for the period that they're allowed here to be workers in such illegal operators.
Haba ng pila sa BI, pakay Chinese ang kapila.
I will not be surprised with that, but at least they are going to the Bureau of Immigration because we are not going after that. We are not going after those illegal workers. Mayroong mga nagsasabi na siguro part na yan ng Chinese Army. I think that's something medyo wild imagination yun. We can still monitor them, although may mga grupo-grupo dyan na
yung mga Chinese kidnapping pero Chinese rather yung mga nagpa-kidnap for ransom.
Other nationalities also
sa atin na record.
Also happens in
dati Koreans yun, ngayon Chinese naman ngayon.
That also happens for other nationalities. And for which we have been working closely with the concerned countries para mabawasan yun. We do not, they have to come in and operate as offshore gamers, then first they have to have the license of PAGCOR. First they have to have their workers registered because as the ministry, the Department of Finance has estimated, we should be getting at least about 2 billion a month from all these workers and from this kailangan natin yung revenues dahil meron kang tertiary education na libre, meron kang irrigation na libre,
universal health care,
lalo na't nabawasan yung income natin sa PCSO for the meantime, dahil ang alam ko binalik na yung loto. Ano pa yung mga libre natin, tertiary education, well, 4 piece Believe it or not, it's now has reached the level of more than 100 people.
Has that made any dent in the communist problem?
Well, yung PORP is a long-term project that takes care of the most disadvantaged families. Meron silang allowance with conditions, conditional cash transfers, na yung bata dapat pakuntay sa eskwelahan. So, in that aspect, we could not say na it hasn't achieved its purpose. We will see in the end. But kung libre ang pasok sa eskwela at meron ka pang kaukulang ambag lagdag para sa healthcare mo at saka sa allowance mo, then we should see a better human resource, a better on the overall.
Less attractive for them to join the communism. Especially
that could translate to that, yes.
Okay. Si Sebi na tayo sa WPS, na yung mga Chinese.
West Philippine Sea.
Yeah. Natatawa lang ako doon sa, nagkaroon na sa Sona rin, yung possession naging position. Ano?
Ah, well, hindi ko sinasadya yun. Sa totoo lang. Pero totoong narinig ko, na sinabi ng presidente, position.
Hindi naman Bisaya sa presidente pagdating sa English.
Hindi, no? Magaling.
Pero kaya pag kung
contexto... Alam mo si presidente, kunyari lang yan na nag-iilonggo, nag-iisaya. Pero kung pakinggan mo mabuti pag nag-English siya na tuloy-tuloy. Ito lang napakagaling niya. Para fiscal yan. Kung argumento at argumento...
Kasi yung contexto, talagang position tama. Pero yung possession, sa pronunciation, talagang possession ng pronunciation.
Tingnan mo itong words niya. You know, hindi ko magaya ang boses ng Pangulo. I cannot go there even to bring the Coast Guard to drive them away. China also claims the property and he is in possession. Yan ang problema. Sila yung in possession and claiming all the resources there as an owner. We are claiming the same but we are not in the position because of that fiasco noong dalawang standoff doon sa Scarborough ni na Albert. So, minensyon talaga. Tayo ang umatras. Pag sabi niya umatras, that was kind of a compromise. Tayo ang umatras, pero hindi umatras yung kapila. So, nawala yung Scarborough. Paborito mo, Scarborough. So, at least ngayon, after 3 years of Duterte administration, we have not lost an island. At may nababalita na nawala daw natin yung Sandy Cay. Sandy Cay is one of the new accretion doon sa tabi ng Pag-asa Island. May tatlong Sandy Cay doon na biglang above sea level, above
nadagdagan ng islands natin.
Tatlo. Dati islands. Parang hindi mo pa mahalata pero ngayon
lumabas na.
Na
climate change din yan.
Well, movement ng water, okay. Climate change or whatever brought that about. But dumami at tumaas yung sand doon ng halos 2 metro na ang taas sa
taas.
Parang kasing tangkad na ng tao. Di, okay. Sa totoo lang, yung ating mga detachment or yung tao natin sa Pag-asa ay pwedeng pumasyal doon at maligo parang beach.
Okay.
Ngunit may usapan tayo na wala mo nang ganun.
So, uninhabited pa rin yun?
Uninhabited. They have never taken
it. How close it is to the Pag-as Kalayaan Island?
The first one is 4 kilometers. The other one is another 2-6. Yung isa, 7.
So, how do we protect it?
We continuously patrol that with the Coast Guard and a Coast Guard vessel and fisheries vessel. Pero, ngayon pa lang, sasabihin ko na sa inyo na napakaraming Chinese fishing vessel doon. Ang bagong record noong February 8 ay... Birthday mo ba? February 8?
February 7 pala.
Bago ka mag-birthday ay dumating sila, umabot sila ng 61.
Wow, okay.
Noong July 24, umabot sila ng 113.
Bakit naman dumaming ganun?
Yun ang aming tinitignan.
Swarming talaga.
And we are I have recommended diplomatic action in regards to that. Ngunit huwag kayong mabahala dahil as of now, nasa cellphone ko pa, kung noong July 25 ay anong tawag doon? Yung prutas pag marami, hintik na hintik.
Oh, hitik na hitik.
Ah, hitik. Yung hitik na hitik. Ngayon ay parang napuros na, parang wala. Napuros. Sa Ilocano naman yan.
Ano yung bisulihan?
Napuros. Na-ani na.
Na-ani na. Yung ano yung mga fishing natin?
Nawala. Yung mga fishing boat doon. Fishing vessels.
Bakit nawala? Yung Chinese fishing vessel nawala. Yung 100, ano? 100 something.
113.
113. Nawala. Kaya nawala?
Kahapon. Wala na.
Okay. Bakit nawala?
Well, weather.
Okay. Bad weather. Kuya, meron daw tropical depression
doon
sa WPS based on pag-asa kanina.
Pag low pressure area. Weather, talagang meron silang pinupuntahan na iba, which is Subi Reef, which is 14 nautical miles away. Tingnan mo to.
It's not within hours in Subi Reef?
Subi Reef is the Samora Reef. Meron silang airstrip doon at saka port.
Wala tayo doon.
Doon sa baba, southwest. Oh. Ito mga yan yung pag-asa. Oh.
Hawangan ko.
Ito yung pag-asa. Iisa na lang yung Coast Guard vessel doon.
Chinese.
Fishing boat, tatlo na lang. Ito, wala o. Oh. Walang kalaman-laman, di ba?
Wala yung swarming na. Kasi may tropical depression, low pressure area daw ngayon, right now. Sabi ng pag-asa.
Ipakita ko naman sa'yo yung
July something. June ba yun?
July 25,
113.
Ito naman siya.
Ang dami nga. Yung red.
Ito naman.
Ang dami nga, around.
Oh, by the way, meron tayong wifi dun sa pag-asa island.
Ano yan, Smart Globe?
It's a private company that has been contracted by the ICP to bring internet to pag-asa island. And to our islands. Sa pag-asa island naman natin, ngayon, ay dumating na yung mga materials para sa ating fishport and soon the seaport na lalagay natin doon. Pag nagawa yung ating rampa doon ngayon, yung other materials for the construction and repair of the airport will now come in. And I'm just telling you that we have not lost any island there. We are strengthening our positions, which are in our possession, dyan sa West Philippine Sea. So, marami kasi nagsasabi na pinamigay na natin ang West Philippine Sea. We have even improved our positions there.
Have you transmitted your proposed not verbal to the DFA?
Oh, pinag-usapan na namin yan. Nagbabay pera kami. So, ni SFA.
Nakakalang si Secretary Ambassador Zhao. Speaking of Ambassador Zhao, are you comforted by his pronouncement at the PLA anniversary that China will not fire the first shot in the West Philippine Sea?
Well, we will not, any country can say that, we will not fire the first shot. Diba? Who will fire the first shot? If you do, if you are a criminal, then you immediately admit to the guilt. But if you say, parang ano lang ito, parang parallelism, analogy. Pag sinabi mo, I will fire the first shot, edi guilty ka na. But I know, because it's a white paper anyway, I will invite you to that. You may want to look at the national defense, wala sa akin dito siguro. The defense white paper of China, which came out in time for the anniversary of the PLA.
Last Monday.
So, siyempre sasabihin nila na we will not fire the first shot. Who will fire the first shot? Sinong country ang magsasabi nun? Wala naman. So, pareho lang tayo. Ganun din naman ang... And so, tayo talaga sa, sa West Philippine Sea, ang presidente, sa SONA, I will always refer to his SONA kasi report niya to sa ating mga kababayan sa lahat ng Pilipino. Sabi niya, on the matter of the Philippines, the West Philippine Sea, the avoidance of armed conflict and the protection of our territorial waters and natural resources compel us to perform a delicate balancing act.
Delicate.
A shooting war is grief and misery multiplier. War leaves widows and orphans in its wake. I am not ready or inclined to accept the occurrence of more destruction, more widows, and more orphans. Should war, even on a limited scale, breaks out, more and better results can be reached in the privacy of a conference room than in a squabble in public. That is why I will do it in a peaceful way as much as possible, mindful of the fact that it is our national pride and territorial integrity that are at stake. So that tells you, that is an expression of the often quoted and repeated stance of independent foreign policy.
Okay. While we agree with you that you have not lost any islands, what their critics are saying, the Duterte administration lost the Hague ruling.
The Hague ruling. Yeah. We have not.
We have practically lost it because we did not claim what we have won.
In the first place, nobody can enforce it for the time being. Nobody can enforce it. The arbitral ruling has no enforcement provisions. And even if a country, no matter how strong it is, would want to enforce it now, it could meet the resistance of China, of course. So let us remember that in all our dealings with the countries in the neighborhood and worldwide, we put national interest above anything else. And so, what are our national interests? One is strong commerce and trade, strong relations, friendly relations with other
people
countries.
People
to people, scientific, military,
trading,
etc. And so, admittedly, there are disputes in the West Philippine Sea and in the South China Sea. On our part, because our territory has been defined by several issuances, including the 1898 Treaty of Paris, which defined our original territory. Later on, followed by the 1935 Constitution. Later on, followed by the 1978 Presidential Proclamation of President Marcos, proclaiming the Kalayaan Island Group as a municipality of Palawan, which today even goes beyond the EEZ. And the 1982 UNCLOS, which gave us the economic rights, it's the definition of the EEZ, and even the extended continental shelf, yun ang ating economic rights. Of course, our territory is also defined by the 1987 Constitution. But tell me, are there other claimants to what we claim as territory? There are. Including Vietnam.
The last time you were here, you narrated to me, but Vietnam has the biggest number of occupied islands.
The most number of islands. There are 11 islands of Vietnam in our EEZ. China, it has now 7 artificial islands. Will start and end in the South China Sea or in the West Philippine Sea? Would you not rather also look at your relations in terms of trade?
Engage with them.
Science, tourism, person to person. Or would you not engage them? Would you not engage them?
Constructive engagement?
Because you could not be destroying each other.
But there's another problem which Defense Secretary Lorenzana bared yesterday or the other day about the Chinese submarines, Chinese ship, Chinese coast guards. And someone is also going inside our own ceilings. Without notice.
Ang binabanggit ni Secretary Lorenzana are the
prior notice.
Are the naval assets of China that passed through the Cebu Channel. Customarily, and we have seen that in our listings, for 6 months, lahat ng military vessels that passed through our territory and in our usual archipelagic ceilings asked for diplomatic clearance.
Yes.
Nagkataon na in our records, we don't have it in record that China asked for diplomatic clearance.
All those?
Yes. And the reason is that it's innocent passage in...
Right of innocent passage.
Right of innocent passage in usual ceiling between Cebuto and Mindanao.
But how do you see it?
We see it as they are in a sense that is correct. There is innocent passage in ceilings, but in our customs and traditions and our agreements with other countries, we always advise the country, the host country, and ask for diplomatic clearance. And there is diplomatic clearance. We even welcome them to dock in our ports.
Special ceremonies.
Whether they are Russian.
Oh, yes.
Whether they are Japanese, American, or Chinese. So, ano lang naman.
Katok lang.
Katok lang. Pasabi lang. After all, if we say we should be dealing with each other at friendly level, or as friends or good neighbors, then yun lang naman ang sinasabi ni Secretary.
So, are you going to include that in your note verbal?
We have.
Are you ready?
We have.
How many incursions have you listed? And how are you able to detect it?
Marireport naman.
Sightings.
It is reported. It is reported. In fact, that incident happened about 2 months ago. Okay. But it has been the subject of diplomatic action.
How many incursions have you recorded and that included in your letter bar?
What we call the
city. You have another 13
as well as incidents.
And so, they are not blind to this, nor are we just keeping ISIS. There are ways of dealing with this kind of problems.
So, my last question before I open the floor. Are the Filipino fishermen happy under the
circumstances?
Are they now able to fish for free or?
On the West Philippine
Sea. Actually, ang ating fishermen
and now the National Task Force
are free to fish anywhere. It's just that they may have implements that are different from what is required. Malalaki yung ibang fishing. Alam mo ba? When you say Chinese fishing boat, those are actually 80 meters deep.
Yung pupangga nga dun sa recto bank.
So, yung ating mga ginagamit, mga basket. And so, that tells you that we must start improving our fishing gadgets. And so, I hope in the long run, we will also have the kind of vessels that could go further from the shoreline.
Bakit pinamigay
natin yun? Ano lang yun? Pan-territorial.
Municipal waters lang yun.
Municipal waters. Kasi...
Ano naman? Sana gano'n din talaga.
Ay, hindi kaya ng gobyerno.
Bakit private commercial dapat yun?
Dapat ang mag-develop ng fisheries natin. Kasi kaya ng gobyerno. Ay, yung private corporation. Marami tayong malalaki ng barko. Bakit ang gusto sa...
Ito ko nga yung Jimber. Wooden hull pa rin. Ito na.
Oh, basti. Siyempre.
Ano na kaya nga na ganun na ganun? Dalang kalaban niya steel hull. Also, how can you encourage private sector, commercial fishing?
Well,
they're not even following our own...
Initiative nila yan.
Hindi, I mean, there are government rules on that kind of matter, yung mga fishing vessels na yan.
And well, si Chara siguro, alam niya kung ano yung mga klaseng bastis ang nakakarating sa Star
Wars. Pero na tayong loss, di ba? Na shipping, fishing,
yung... Meron tayo, safe, but it is not...
Safety at sea.
It is safe. Yung mga bastis natin, yung Dikating, ay nako, maniwala ka.
Nasa high sea sila, how can that...
Yung nga lang, ang catch nila would not go beyond probably metric ton and a half. So, ano lang? So kung walo sila sa isang basnig, edi kung makakuha sila ng 2 tons, yun ang kanilang produkto patuloy sa...
Can you just update us what happened now to this Mindoro Fisher Folk in 22, yung ka-Jimber na yan?
We already have the, on the recto incident, we already have the report of the Coast Guard.
How about the Chinese side?
So we would now have the make the meeting between our between the two governments to compare the reports.
Does that happen up to now?
It has not been finalized, but we are sure that because China has admitted that the ship that that brought about the allision,
the Chinese vessel.
The Chinese vessel. So we expect that that ship and the owner thereof would be fined and pay amelioration penalty.
They have not even identified the owner. They have not even identified the captain, the ship captain.
Madali na lang yun kasi alam na yung pangalan ng barko.
Have they been, under Chinese laws, have they been, charged with any particular,
Not yet on their side, but this is now the subject that has to be followed through, yung comparison ng reports.
Your Chinese investigators have investigated our Fisher folk. Have they come to investigate?
I am not sure if they have done that. Kaya nga dalawang site ang mag-investiga. Mm. So, from our side and from their
side. They cannot investigate or interview our fisher folk?
They have no authority to do that.
Okay.
They can only gather information.
But how about us?
We have gathered the information. It was in fact volunteered by China itself, the name of the ship.
Okay. So, just to update us, anong status nun? Nandun pa rin, hindi pa na sisynchronize
there
yung report.
There will have to come a meeting on the results of the investigation.
And compensation? And
compensation, damages, etc.
Our legal suit, where are we going? Meron tayong IMO?
The legal suit would be...
IMO, yung International Maritime Organization, di ba, file tayo ng protest?
We have not. It has to be filed by the ship that was
Gimber. But DFA was the one that filed.
It will have to take care of that. We have left that to DFA.
Yes, okay. Now the floor is now open for your questions. Please identify yourself and shoot your question. Sarah?
Hi, sir. Balik pa po sandali din sa yung influx of Chinese nationals coming to the country. Pina-perceive niyo po ba ito as a security threat sa buong context?
Well, kung akong tatanungin mo bilang National Security Advisor, I have the tendency to look at it as a threat. I'm on the cautious side. Because when foreigners, regardless of nationality, come in, and their intent is not clear, or when some of them are undocumented or have wrong documentation, false documentation, meaning some of them would come in as tourists and yet end up as workers, then very familiar tayo dyan dahil marami sa atin ang napunta sa ibang bansa din na nagturista, di ba? Pero they ended up as workers. Nagawa ko pa yata yun. In another life, in another assignment. So, pagtatanungin mo ako kung security concern yan, natural, sasabihin ko sa iyo na I have concerns on that.
You won't be doing your job if you're not concerned.
Yes, in fact, that's my concern. Kung we have such things as rules on naturalization, rules on labor, if they're not followed, then bakit nagkakaganon? Ito na nga.
Okay.
Sinasabi natin, meron bang difference ang ating immigration officers? Tatanungin ko si Commissioner Morente dahil ang pagkaalam ko sa kanya, napaka-stricto niya. Ngunit nakikita ba niya lahat yung ginagawa ng mga tao niya? Kung nababantayan nila kung ano yung pagpasok. But let me tell you that there had been interagency meetings between DOLE, PIR, Bureau of Immigration, Finance, and management to look into all these things. It is something that we have to look into simply because when you have so many stories about people entering subdivisions, buying up properties,
yeah,
and then you would see something like a rotation of every 8 hours of people going in and out, then you would begin to wonder what they're doing. Ganun pala, by shifting na sila. So, service, na service sila, ganun. You would also be start getting worried when a whole building, condominium tower, is occupied by only one nationality, where you might not be able to guard all their activities. Some unwelcome activities could transpire there. So, kailangan agapan natin. We want a healthy investment investment opportunities in terms of housing and all this on these condominiums. We want more tourists, but there is always the other side of the coin, so to say. So we must not let our guards down. And so if you ask me again, it is my concern. It is my concern. But that is not to say that it should now be the overarching concern of everyone. There are people who are taking care of that problem. Kaya lang, talagang very pronounced, di ba? May mga report dyan na, naka-alfard sila lahat. Naka, yung mga buong resort, kinukuha na nila.
Yung band.
In one aspect, you would be glad because parang nababuy up yung properties. Dumadami ang turista. But, as I said, there is always the other side of the coin. Titingnan natin yun. So, while it is my concern, I'd like to be very balanced about it.
So, ano po yung concrete action na may expect natin from government regarding that?
Well, I would like to bring out the name of Secretary Dominguez because he says that in my computation, if we are to tax all of them, the workers themselves should bring in terms of revenue, about 2 billion a month. And di kung kwentahin mo yon, times 12 is 24, which is approximating the incomes of the BPOs. So, malaking bagay yon, yung income na yon, revenues natin. But as I said, so in order to achieve that, you have to document arrivals. You have to know where they are deployed. You have to know whether the gaming companies that they are working with are registered with PACOR. Kailan maayos lahat. Otherwise, kung papayag ba tayo na in your neighborhood, you would want all the people to be somehow registered and known by the neighborhood, di ba? So, expand that. Kung lahat naman unregistered na dito sa Manila, mukhang hindi maganda para sa atin. So, we want to make our cities as warm as possible in terms of welcoming tourists, but we must take the necessary safeguards.
So, kahapon, si SMB, sinabi niya na inconsistent yung actions ng China sa pronouncements nila. Binalikan nga niya yung Scarborough incidents as signs of bullying. What do you think about SNB's statements?
Have
you echo it or
divide it? I've yet to read the transcript, but somehow I heard it on your channel. Kineri naman lahat ng channels, ano? But you go back to Scarborough. We sent in there the gray ship, our own Coast Guard cabin before, but it has become the Navy ship to accost fishermen. And we have provisions and regulations that can deputize the Navy to, in fact, enforce fisheries laws. So pumunta tayo doon, Navy. Hinarapan ng Coast Guard. Na mas marami pa. Alam nyo naman, yung Coast Guard nila ay 100 meters, 94 meters. Ano yung hinarap natin doon ng Coast Guard cutter, barko natin? I think it was 84 meters. So mas maliit, hinarapan ng 10. At marami pang Chinese fishing vessels. Alam mo bang fishing vessel nila? Alam mo, mas kabisado mo yun. Ikaw ang punta ng punta sa Scarborough. Walang cutting, di ba? 80 meters. Some are even longer than that. Ganun ang fishing vessel nila ko. Di ba? E di, outnumbered ka. Like the Dickens. I mean, you are so overwhelmed, overpowered, outnumbered. Do you call that bullying? Or you were in the wrong place at the wrong time?
Kayo, sir, what do you call that?
Oh, well, there are other terms for bullying. One is outmaneuvering. One is outnumbering. One what? Is forcing your will.
What is your word of choice?
Outfox.
Parang sabi
ko,
Chinese.
I mean, tapos ang usapan ninyo eh, magwi-withdraw kayo kung totoo yung accounts nila. Eh, kung magwi-withdraw na sabay, bakit nauna ka? When you withdrew ahead of the other side, and they did not leave, then, from that time on, you have lost Scandal.
Nag-withdraw sila kasi bagyo noon eh.
Eh, hindi. Kailangan magkaroon ng provisions sa ating mga barko. For one reason, for one reason. Anyway, nandiyan na yan. But it remains a fact that we lost Scarborough because of some...
May question doon.
Scarborough.
Good morning, sir. I'm Ella Promete.
Okay.
May ongoing, sir, na meeting ng world leaders sa Thailand ngayon for the ASEAN. And still part of the agenda is the code of conduct for the South China Sea. Meron po bang any update? And ano yung mga provisions na pinupush ng Philippines to be included in the code of conduct?
That's part of the ASEAN structure. I do not have the details of it now, but remember that the chairman of the COC talks, code of conduct with China, is the president himself. So if it is ongoing now, it must be, I would imagine, Undersecretary Manalo. Or baka nandun na si Secretary Loxin. Because at this time of the year, you start with the ASEAN meetings sometime in April, and then you go to the summit. It is summit sometime October, November. So that's part of it, the construct.
May sideline meetings with foreign minister too.
So, given the recent incidents, ano po yung mga particular provisions
na pinapos ng government? Ang code of conduct simply tells you that ang bottom line yan is yung rules to govern the South China Sea. Like non-occupancy, non-building, non-militarization. Those are things that I'll talk about. It. And we hope that the COC talks will be finished in 3 years' time. So, it is indeed something that we look forward to. Kailangan matapos na to. At the same time, between China and us, the Philippines, we have what we call the bilateral mechanism for consultations. Meron din tayo. Doon din natin sinasabi yung mga nagiging problema natin sa kanila. So it's not all about outfoxing or
we just had one, diba? A few days ago.
Bilateral. About 3 weeks na. That's the BCM. So doon natin binibigay yung mga positions natin kung anong problema natin sa kanila at yung problema nila sa atin.
Okay.
What is your stance, sir, na si President Duterte gustong itap yung U.S. participation and parang to guard the situation in South China Sea, but China, on the other hand, does not want or wants to exclude U.S. in the...
Well, that is one of the options. It can come in. That could be triggered by... If you remember that we have the mutual defense treaty with the U.S., so it could come in some instances. In fact, to the extent, to the extreme, sinabi nga ng Presidente, I want to call now the 7th Fleet, and let's go to war. Is that something feasible? Is that what you want?
Okay. Well, we have a question here from GNA.
So, we know that there is the MDT to that we have as in our arsenal, so to say, but it may not be invoked as much as we want. After all, by limitations, including the permission or the approval of the U.S. Congress for some deployments. And of course, it can be used only if there's an attack on a private, public vessels and our own territory.
Okay, thank you. GMA7.
Oh.
Hi, sir. Gino, GMA7. Sir, yung going back to yung swarming na nakita natin, is this somehow, well, in relation to yung pagprotesta natin, o balak ihain na protesta, is this somehow government's recognition of yung swarming o yung Chinese fishing militia na tactic nung employed by China in the West Philippine Sea? Recognition by ito?
This is what... It is a subject of continuing study because we say it's swarming, but when we look at the composition of the vessels that are there, we saw seven cargo vessels. Pero wala namang laman na pang-construct, halimbawa. So, you can say, hindi kaya nagre-resupply lang ang mga to. Kaya nandun sila lahat.
Or taking out something.
Parang logistics run nila. Alam mo na, you have 100 fishing vessels. So, saan kukuha ng pagkain? Saan kukuha ng provision? So, it could be like that. Or, it could be to prevent you from patrolling in that area, or it could be a dry run. Di ba?
Dry run.
Hindi pwede mag-dry run sa dagat.
Wet run.
Wet
run na sir.
Di ba? So many possibilities. But it's simply that. Nung 25, 113 yung facing aggressions. Pero ngayon, wala. Tatlo.
Sinabi, low pressure kaya lang yun.
Weather pala. Weather pala. At saka, baka, well, we want to read the minds of the People's Liberation Army, Navy, but we may not be correct all the time. So, suffice to say that we are aware of that. And kaya nga, kailangan patibayan din natin yung ating mga position doon. Position. In our positions.
Position and possession, yeah.
Sir, follow-up lang. Sir, on a medyo personal note. Sir, meron bang strategy tayo or may mga restrictions na ina-apply sa PAGASA and West Philippine Sea in general because over the past several months, gusto natin makita yung mga development sa PAGASA but we understand the National Task Force and the other agencies do not want media or ma-highlight yung ginagawa natin doon at yung access to our health territories. But sir, konting explanation.
Hindi naman sa tinatago namin sa inyo, but sometimes it's better addressed in the quiet atmosphere of some conference rooms or some briefing rooms.
Baka ma-agitate ng China kung nakita yun.
Yes, and remember. But how to address? We have been depending so much on the inputs of friendly countries, but in a short while we will have our own equipment in terms of unmanned aerial vehicles, high flying, that could look into this, and we will also have our imagery satellite. So, mas diretso na tayo. Mas diretso na tayo. And all we have to do now is probably increase our Coast Guard vessels, our fisheries vessels, kasi alam naman natin na yung karamihan sa mga Coast Guard vessels natin ay 44 meters, yung galing sa Japan na 10. At may parating na 84 meters na dalawa. Gusto rin nating paramihin yung ating mga barko sa Navy at mga eroplano natin. So, it's all, it must be a continuous build-up of capabilities.
Hardware
as well as human resources. But we assure you that despite the claims of others that they have actually given up some islands, no, we are strengthening our islands. In fact, last year we were able to put up there five lighthouses. So if that does not mean anything to you, then you read on lighthouses and tell me what they mean. And we are building another five.
In the KIG.
Yeah, puntahan natin. By the way, through the efforts of the National Task Force, we have been able to buy one Marine Scientific Research ship of the UP MSI. Ganado silang pumunta ngayon doon. UP will buy another four out of our effort. So we will have more Marine Scientific Research vessels that will add to our capabilities of the MSR of Navy and the ENR as well as of the PC.
Napostpone din ba yung pagpunta?
No, hindi. Napunta tayo doon. We have our 2 years na tayong umiikot dyan ng aming MSR. So, when we have banned use the entry of foreign MSRs, we have substituted our humble means of doing it.
Lima na yun, lima na pala.
But we hope that soon we can have again the partnerships with accredited foreign MSRs that will go by the rules. Meaning, papayag sila na mag-board tayo, papayag silang ibibigay sa atin yung resulta ng Marine Scientific Research.
Okay. Curious lang ako, may iba tayo ng topic kasi nabanggit mo yung sa PCSO and the counterintelligence. Na-verify nyo na kaya explode and suspended the PCSO or game was based on your counterintelligence na naging SDL ang extortion activities ng police and other local government.
Alam mo kung sinong pinakamaraming information? The President. Because he has so many sources. Hindi lang yung kanyang operating units, but many from the civilians, many from the leadership of PCSO itself. So the President was hitting the target right. Pag ginawa niya yon,
parang hindi surgical na kasi pati loto na yung list naman pala yun.
Oh, para minsan na lang muna. Anyway,
how serious is the STL and weapons still operating?
Oh, well, let me not. Ayokong pangunahan, pero marami rin akong alam. Let it come out in the investigation. Basta sa STL, parang na-mismanage.
STL?
Yes.
Kasi nag-ship ang focus at anti-drug. Kaya napabayaan yung anti-vetting.
Yun ang problema. Kung may trabaho kang gagawin, dapat hindi mo pababayaan yung trabaho. Huwag mong gawing excuse yung anti-drug.
So remember,
I opened with that and I closed with the same remarks on catharsis, which is
reforming
what we individually or collectively need to do today, not tomorrow, but today. Self-purgation, followed by the resolve to do what is right and proper. And it is good for the health of the nation.
Wala na kayo tanong?
On that, I will take the last question.
Okay.
On that note, I'll take the last question. Gagawa na ako ng
Christmas anniversary. Sir, clear ko lang yung sa March.
sinasabi nyo kanina yung recommendation, i-recommend nyo yung extension ng martial law. Tingin nyo, mga gano'ng kahabang panahon pa yung kailangan?
Oh, well, alam nga naman mag-extend ka ng 1 month. So, you might as well go for 1 year. But that is very iffy kasi, halimbawa, si Mayor Sara, sabi niya, ayoko na ng martial law. Very right. Because maganda yung kanilang security. I remember that because when I was J3 in 2003, Colonel Pangilinan then, who was the task force Davao, really made a good set up there. Dinagdagan namin ng 5 cavalry units. Mas mura kaysa police. Tapos, dagdag din sa police. And then yung lahat ng kanto ng Davao, especially the Davao proper, talagang nabantayan. At saka matbula naman, pinaganda ng pinaganda, including gadgets, including 911. So, ano pang kailangan mo? Mamarchalin po pa yung Davao? Kung lahat ng city at towns ay ganun, remember, the perfect 911 is in Davao City. Eh di, dapat lang na hindi na siguro kailangan ng martial law sa'yo. Eh kung nandun ka naman sa gitna ng Marawi, ay nako, eh di, ibang usapan yon, di ba? So, one, the president will listen, of course, to the local officials, but he will listen to the troops on the ground also. And, of course, our collective advice dito sa national office.
So, magiging selective na lang, sir?
It can be, but if an improved Human Security Act and Counter-Terrorist Act is passed, then why go for martial law? 3 araw lang binibigay sa iyo na detention period yan. Tapos ang dami po pang sasabihin, kung sinabing martial law, parang akala mo...
Napakagulo.
Akala mo, isinala mo ang Kongreso. Di ba? Hindi. It's not the martial law of before. Not that. Well, huwag na natin pag-usapan kasi baka masabi pa nyo na mabuti yung martial law noon. Ah, masabi ko pala. In a sense, it was. Di ba? Baka siguro gusto nyo. Dahil nagkagulo lang sa Negros, gusto nyo ulit martial law. May mga paraan pa naman. Di ba? So,
before I release you, dumating na ba yung tatlong choppers from Jordan?
Oh, our pilots are training. Nung nakipag-meeting ako minsan kay with some several ministers, nag-meeting kami sa Aqaba process, host si King Abdullah. Hindi ko alam kung natuwa siya sa report ko, eh nag-commit siya ng 2 Cobra helicopters.
Ah, 2 lang ba? Kala ko tatlo.
Sabi niya, baka dagdagan ko kaya. Depende sa usapan. Our pilots are now training there, but may iba pang donations ang Jordan sa atin, si King Abdullah II, RPG, M14, armor vehicles.
Donations? Eh?
Yes. Donations? Because I made a good report. No, bilib lang siya kay Presidente, actually. Nung pumunta si Presidente doon ng state visit, pinakita niya yung capability ng ano.
Jordan.
May nakita si Presidente na naka-truck parang armor bag. Tapos umangat na parang forklift. Tapos enclosed. Pag second floor yung kalaban mo, akyatin mo lang yun, naka-enclose ka. Maggandahan si Presidente doon. Ang nangyari, after 2 months, may dumating dito na isang unit mo.
Wow!
Ganyan si Presidente.
Anong tawag doon?
El Sater.
Nasaan na yun?
Armored Assault. Nandiyan, sa KSQ, papakita. Magagamit natin. But, well, wala naman tayong katumbas ng Cobra ngayon dito. Armored helicopter yun.
Your closing remarks and announce your anniversary today?
Well, I think it's on everyone for this opportunity coming as it is on the anniversary of the NSA. Rest assured that we take the word of the President when he said that we must do better. And if we have to do better, we must reform what is bad in us. Sinasama namin ang sarili namin sa reforma na yan. Because by reforming and doing the correct actions, we will know that we could be of better service. We could be a better part of government. So, abangan ninyo ang National Task Force on Ending the Local Communist Armed Conflict. and the things that we are doing in preventing and countering violent extremism. I am, by the way, the cabinet officer for Region 1, but I'm helping the Cordillera cabinet officer, which is Secretary Abuel, who went to law school in Baguio and topped the bar in the year.
Abuel,
si Janet Abuel, DBM.
DBM Baguio.
Region 2 is Bello.
Region
1. On Region 1, so tatlo kami doon. Tandem kami tatlo. Meron bang tandem na
trio.
Trio kami. Trio kami doon because you cannot really solve the insurgency problem in Region 2 or Region 1 at the exclusion of the other two. So, maganda yung
kailan teamwork. Kailan na launch?
We have launched it.
We are now,
we are now in the, as I said, while we are in the planning and organizing stage, we are also performing. Kaya nakita nyo na, ay, hindi nyo alam siguro yun, na napatigil na namin yung funding ng mga ibang NGO dyan going to the NPA.
Kasi wala na kayong cabinet members na lefties, tinanggal yun na.
Wala akong sinasabing gano'n.
Eh, sinasabi mo lang kanina, si Mariano eh.
Wala akong sinasabing gano'n.
Sinasabi mo lang kanina, si Mariano eh.
Pero alam natin lahat yun.
Kayo rin nag-create ng problem, okay? On that note, I would like to thank Secretary Esperon for being with us today. And as usual, guys, please release him from ambush interview kasi mga madali. Kagawa pa siya ng speech. So we'll just have a photo.